Today I'm going to try and fix my Telwin plasma cutter. It's the Telwin plasma 34 with the inbuilt compressor, so you don't need a separate air supply. I've had this one probably about 10 years. The only problems I've had with it is I keep melting the torch heads. Lack of skill, I would call it. Anyway, I've got a new torch head to fit to it. It's the S45 Trafimet style torch, although this isn't a genuine one. This is a cheap knockoff copy, but we'll see how it goes. Right, found some tools. I'll time to take it apart. Not many screws left in it because it melted the last time and I just threw it back together. Yeah, the problem with these, if you are cutting into plate and it blows back into the tip, it can melt the inside of the head, and that doesn't do any good at all. Right, what else is holding this together? The cap off. That one is pretty well melted. Yeah, that has been bad. Auto bait clip on the bottom. Right, yes, pretty well melted inside here as well. I think that was a quick fix. But the main fur wires have melted off the body. And the case is melted as well. Switch right there. So I need to get a knife and cut the insulation back. It's bolts to the air pipe there. And we've got a couple of connections for the little contacts that go onto the cap, and then the switch connections as well. And the switch is going to use the switch. Yeah, I'll get that sorted in a minute. We've got a spanner. Just right. That's the old melted head. When air pressure comes into this, it blows this piston back in and lets the air flow out. That's the theory. Right, what wires have we got? Oh, that will need to get spliced onto the new one. Yeah, mainly that one. Previous one or two have been spliced on before. You can see I've replaced it twice. Right, go and get the new one out of the box. Try not to mix up all the screws. Oh, nice loose ring there. The nozzle. The cup. This cup's got six holes in it to let the air through. For the compressor version, we need a cup with, I think it's either two or one hole in them. So I'll need to either plug some of the holes up in this one or get another cup for it. That's it. As you can see, the leads go in the back here, and couple of little clips that they can go in. And similarly on this one, you've got various leads. This is the main power one that needs to splice into this fella here. And then you've got the two little contacts that go up here. There's one on this side, just there, and the other one on this side in the case, and they contact on that surface of the nozzle cap. Then your little micro switch goes in there. Right, all we've got to do is splice these wires somewhere neatly so that it all fits back together. Right, I shall need to go and find some crimps and get that sorted in a minute. I'll put some heat shrink over the joint. Have it all shortened out. Right, that should do that. I don't have any small crimps like these ones, so I shall probably have to cut this one off and splice it into that wire there. Or failing that, I could solder it direct onto the terminal there. Might just solder it on. Save having a big bulky solder splice further up. Yeah, probably do that. We'll get a soldering iron. Right, I'll get that prepared. Right, we'll just try and get this. The thermostat's a bit wonky in this hot air gun. Right, that's a low temperature solder melted in there. Just leave it for a short while to cool down so we don't pull it apart. Yeah, still a bit hot. So the next one to do is to splice into this bit coming up the denture. Right, that's it. That's melted in. And it's just a case of fishing all that back in, putting it in neatly so it doesn't foul anything. The main body goes in. Drops in there. We said that'll go underneath there. Go on the micro switch. Sure it doesn't catch on anything. Cram in there. That seems to be moving okay. The ball seems to be moving. All we need are some screws. I need a bit of screws. Screws go very well in there. Don't seem to tighten up. I wasn't forcing them. Yeah, I think these screws like going in once in these cheap Chinese plastic rip-offs. Okay. do. Seems to be reasonably tight. And that ring can go in either way, it looks the same both sides. Yeah. There's a couple of little air holes on the side of that. That goes on there, and I need to have a look and see if we've got another one of these, because that one won't work with this setup. There's some pressure there. All goes together. In theory. Right, that looks like all I can do here for the moment. I need to go out to the workshop, see if we've got another cup, and we can give it a try. Success!